بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ويلكم ايفري ون ايام حادي مسكين هيتي بارمنت وبسيدرين جاينيكولوجي يونيفرسيتي اوف بيشا كوليج اوف ميديسين سعودي ارابيا ذا اكتيفيتي توداي از اباوت ابروتش تو هيستوري اند اكزامينيشن ان اوبستريك اند جاينيكولوجي باي ذا اند اوف ذيس ليكتشر ذا ستودنت ويل بي ايبل تو اوبتين ان ابروبريتلي ريكورد ذا كومبليت اوبستريكال هيستوري اند اوبستريكال هيستوري اند تو بيرفورم جنرال to be able to perform general obstetric examinations and to demonstrate abdominal examination as well. Various principles of obstetric history taken is we have to respect the patient, confidentiality and privacy are very important. Information should be logical and also in chronological sequences. History should guide a clinicians to make a diagnosis and perform proper and relevant investigation as well. It is important to build a rapport with the patient. It's important to build a rapport with the patients to come to a professional diagnosis, to perform relevant investigations as well, to give a correct treatment and to provide the proper counseling. Essential prerequisites to seek a permission from patient, grade the patient, dress a code with a pronouns and identity badge. Make sure a sister or a female attendant will be with you and be gentle and sensitive with the patient as well. Regarding the obstetric history, bio data, which is a personal and social history, merely on both from, you should to ask about the name, age, nationality, occupation, marital status, relations, and a wife, daughter of someone's address, obstetric formula is very important, gravity, parity, abortion, living ectopic, ectopic pregnancy is there. Last minute serial period in order to calculate expected day of delivery. It's important. The obstetric formula, gravida, para, abortion, or ectopics, living babies, last period of gestations. E.g., if she tell me, if I consider a lady of gravity 3, para 2, plus 0, L2, 40 week of gestations, 9 months plus 7 days is 40 weeks. So the above woman is pregnant for the third times. She had a 2 living baby, bara 2. She had no abortions before. She had the living 2 living baby. Period of gestation, present pregnancy is the 40 weeks. Then complained and duration should be treated in chronological orders. Pain, vomiting, bleeding, discharge, fever, etc. History of the birth and illness is very important in order to elaborate or expand each complaint in chronological orders. Explain. It's important to explain the event happened in hospital stay and what treatment she received. First trimester, second trimester, and third trimesters, and history of labor, don't forget it. Trimester-wise history, we take an example for the first trimester. Yeah, history of pain, lower abdomen, bleeding per vagina, fever, with chills, rigors, skin rash, intake of any drugs, radiation exposures, and UTI symptoms. And don't forget to ask about any investigations like ultrasounds, urine pregnancy test, and any blood test has been done. History of any operations is very important, or any other trauma or interventions done. Drug and vaccination history, whether she's booked with any doctors, if so, how many visits she has had. So regarding second trimester, it's very important to ask about history of pain in the lower abdomen, bleeding per vagina, fetal movement, symptoms of anemia, and hypertension, and antepartum hemorrhage, EBH, and hyperemesis gravidarum as well. time of quickening is very important. The first perceptions, which means the first perceptions of the fetal movement by the mothers in the prime, it will be about 18 weeks. 18 weeks in 18 to 20 weeks in the multi para 16 to 18 weeks. Weight gain, it should be around 5 kg. Also, history of headache, blurred vision, edema of feet, change in the color and quantity of urine is important. Also, any investigation like ultrasounds, urine, pregnancy test, and any blood test has been done or should be asked about. Immunization history, history of any operation, or any other trauma or investigation has been done also. And whether she is booked with any doctors, if she, how many visits she had, and history of the drug taken, we should do raise it. Regarding the third trimester history of pain, the lower abdomen, bleeding, vagina, weight gain, again, is around 5 kg, history of headache, blurred vision, edema of the feet, change in the color and quantity of the urine is important. Any investigation like ultrasound, urine pregnancy test, and any blood test, history of an operation, and any other trauma and a trauma or investigation done. Whether she booked with any doctors, if she, how many visits she had, history of the drugs, if it is postnatal case, labor and delivery details, and postnatal period details is very important to ask about. Regarding her past obstetric history, is very important to ask about gravida, para, and abortions. So firstly, to be clear and to elaborate each pregnancy like date and time of delivery. Each delivery, each pregnancy details should be considered as a separate items. And is it full term or preterm should be cleared. Hospital or home delivery, normal or cesarean delivery, male or female baby, weight of the baby, any complication in the delivery, and problems for the newborn is there. Here with some terminology, it is important for you to know this terminology. For example, gravida. Gravida means a woman who is or has been pregnant, most early during pregnancy. If the lady is pregnant, if now pregnant, use gravida. Prima gravida, a woman who is in or who has experienced her first pregnancy. And multi gravida, a woman who has been pregnant more than once. Nulli gravida, a woman who had never been pregnant and not now pregnant. Multibara, a woman who has given a birth two or more times. It's called multibara. And nulli bara, a woman who has never given birth, who has never had a pregnancy progress beyond the gestational age of an abortions. Regarding the ministerial history, it is very important to ask about the duration of cycles, number of days of flow, regularity of the menstruations, last ministerial period, and then to calculate the expected day of delivery. Here is how to calculate expected day of delivery. We use Nigel's formula like that. To add 9 months and 7 days to the first day of the last menstrual period. Regarding Hegri dates, we add 9 months and 15 days, 15 days instead of 7 days to the first day of the last menstrual period. These rules need to be adjusted or recalculated in the following condition for the accuracy. Irregular period, woman, on contraceptive pills on the prolonged period. In this condition, we should adjust or recalculate the salicylic syrup. Early scan is very important in estimating expected day of delivery as well. Contraceptive history. Regarding this important section of history, usage of oral pills, should to ask about if there is any IUCD, barriers, duration, and any side effect if there. Past medical and surgical history. Any history of medical illness like tuberculosis, diabetes, hypertension, epilepsy, SLE, and so on, this should be asked about. And is she on treatment now? We should ask about this. And is she following up with any physicians and what type of surgery she had undergone if there is? Family history, any history of medical illness like tuberculosis, diabetes, hypertension, SLE, and so on. So congenital anomalies, heart disease, multiple pregnancy within the family is very important to ask about. Chromosomal disease and metabolic disease is very important, and history of consanguinity is important also. Regarding the drug and allergy history, you should to ask about drugs, food, and any others. Things. Social and personal history is very important. Occupation, income, living status, level of education, total family members, and also if there is, you should ask about smoking, alcohol intake, drug abuse, sleep, bowel habits, diet, and so and so. This regarding the obstetrical history items and what should we ask about. Regarding the general examinations, general obstetric examination, we should look for pallor, cyanosis, jaundice, hydration, status, and oral hygiene is important also. Thyroid and any neck swellings is very important. Also, breast examination, globin, glutinicia, edema, feet, varicose vein in the legs, and so on and so. Vital signs. Importance, blood pressures, pulse rate, respiratory rate, temperature, weight, and height in order to calculate the body mass index. Systematic examination should be for the central nervous system, cardiovascular system, respiratory system, GIT, genitalia, urinary system, locomotor system, and so on. Obstetrical or abdominal examination. We will talk in details about these sections. Firstly, the traditional way, you know all, by inspection, size of abdomen distension, symmetrical or asymmetrical, we should document about this. Umbilicus inverted or flat or reverted. Fetal movement, if appears, scars in cord veins, hernia, sides, we should do, yani look for umbilical, paraumbilical, and inguinal hernia is there. And we should comment about linea nigra, which is a dark of pigmented lines from the sternum to the symphysis pubis, and also striae gravidarum, which is the recent strange mark, are purplish in colors, and also striae albicans, which is the old strange mark, look for a silvery white appearance. Palpations, importance, symphyofundal height to measure, to be measured in centimeters, and measure from 20 weeks onward, estimation of number of fetus. It will give you an idea about this also. Yani it is a single fetus perform. If it is a single fetus, we should perform double maneuvers, which consists of the four items, fundal and high, fundal height and grips, fundal heights and grips, fundal heights, lateral or umbilical grips, superficial and deep pelvic grips. Appropriate cross is usually estimated to be the number of feet station in centimeters at 30 weeks, the symphysial fundal height should be about 30 centimeters plus or minus 2 centimeters. This is normal. For example, plus 2 centimeters from 20 weeks until 36 week gestation, plus or minus 3 centimeters between 36 to 40 gestation, plus or minus 4 centimeters at 40 week gestation. With advanced pregnancy, we should add more centimeters in order to calculate it accuracy. These figures reflects the facial fundal height calculations. As you know that, 40 weeks and so on. So you should do, look at it carefully later on. And how will you estimate gestational age for fundal heights? Measurement of fundal height will be like this. Divide the abdomen by an imaginary line passing through the umbilicus. Divide the lower abdomen in three parts with two lines between the pubic symphysis and the umbilicus. And lastly, divide the upper abdomen into three parts again with two imaginary lines between the umbilicus and the sternum tightis. Now that we have three landmark. Here is the sternum, here is the umbilicus, here is the symphysis pubis. Okay. Loblet maneuvers or grips, it's famous by grips like this. The ferris maneuvers, one or both hands are placed over fundus and the fetal part identified like this. And B, the second maneuvers here, this is the second maneuver, the palmar surface of one hand is used to locate the back of the fetus and the other hand to feel the irregularities, such as hand and feet. While here, third maneuver, thumb and third fingers are placed to grasp like this here, to grasp presenting part over the pubic symphysis. And lastly, here, is the force maneuvers. Both hands are used to outline the fetal head. We want to define fetal lies. Fetal lie is a relationship of longitudinal axis of the fetus to that of the uterus. For example, longitudinal fetal head or reach palpable over the pelvic and so on, as here is clear in this image. Presentation, the part of the divine as a part of the fetus, which occupies the lower pole of the uterus. And it's expressed like cephalic, podalic, shoulder, reach, and others. And this three illustration show the different type of presentations. Ferris and the second maneuver, this is the ferris maneuvers like this, and this is the second maneuver like this, third and the fourth maneuver as well. And when the greatest horizontal plane, the biparietal has passed the plane and the pelvic rims and the head, this is called engagement, okay? Engagement, and the diverse of the fingers, engage head like this here, and here it will be also no engagement here, and there is engagement here in this. The presentation, a part of the fetus overlying the pelvic rim, which is these diminutions, and the presentation is expressed as cephalic, breech, and others would be shoulders or about. Amniotic fluid volume, tense abdomen, there is always tense abdomen with the fetal part, and not easily palpable. Compact abdomen is the fetal part, yeah, easily palpable. Auscultation of the fetal heart. The fetal heart is the best heart at the anterior shoulders of the fetus using a Doppler ultrasound device from about 12-week gestations. Fetal cystoscopes, which is called thinners, from about 24 weeks is the best time to use it. In a brief presentation, we should to consider that it is often heard at or above the level of the maternal umbilicals, and the rate and the risk of the fetal heart should be determined over 1 completed minutes. Here is the fetal heart monitoring by fetoscopes and location of the fetal heart in the different presentation of the, according to position, which is shown here. Regarding vaginal examination can be performed by speculums or digital examinations. It's not a part of the routine obstetric examination, but may be indicated in diagnosis rupture of the membrane or one set of labors or one set of labor aspects. We summarize that Mrs. X is 21 years old, housewife, married for 2 years primary, or gravida for breast 3+0, and had living 3 at 33 weeks, admitted with a high blood pressure for admission and the further management. This as assignment for you, and how to deal with this patient and taking details of obstetric history. Regarding the second part of this lectures is about gynecological history. Biodata is the same like that in obstetric history. Complaint and duration. The common complaint in obstetrics patient like abnormal uterine bleeding, infertility, vaginal discharge, pelvic pain, and so on and so. This is a very this is a common complaint in obstetrics in gynecological patients. History of the present illness is very important. Menstrual history, age of menarche, durations of cycles, amount of flow, pain with period like which is called dysmenorrhea, premenstrual symptoms, intermenstrual spottings or bleeding, and date of last menstrual period is important in this considers. Obstetric history, what should to ask about? Past surgical, past surgical history, family history, treatment history, allergy history, sexual history, husband, prevention of pregnancy, protection against STDs, and social and personal history is very important. Past gynecological history, any previous BID, endometriosis, fibrosis, etc., any operations, hormonal replacement therapy is very important also to be reflected. Regarding examination in gynecological patient, general examination, systemic examination, abdominal examination, this is very important. Local or genitalia examination, periospeculum examination, bare vagina, or by manual pelvic examination, vaginal rectal examination, and in order to reach professional diagnosis and differential diagnosis as the end. It's very important to know some information about the positioning, patient lying, so being patient lying supine on the examination table with the head elevated at 30 to 45 degrees. This is very important and famous position as well. This for the pelvic examination, which is called lithotomy positions. This is a dorsal positions also, and this lithotomy positions is ideal for examination under anesthesia, and this external genitalia. And this is speculum, how to perform the speculum examinations, okay? This speculum examination, and this is Koska's speculum, used for the speculum examination, and this seems speculums also use it there. And this anterior vaginal wall retractors, these retractors, the famous in gynecological patients, they deal with by gynecological patient. This is which is called bimanual examination, and we should perform bimanual examination in a certain condition. You know it letters palpates vaginal wall. As you insert your finger to for tenderness, cyst induces mass and growth. And also you should to identify the cervix, noting the following positions. It is at anterior or posterior shape, is it pure shape or not? Consistency is firm or soft, size, uterine enlargement, just pregnancy, benign or malignant tumor, the uterus. Should be 5.5 to 8 centimeters long, so normal. This to show the bimanual examination while this rectal vaginal examinations. This also, and there is many indication for bimanual vaginal examinations. And here you listed all the indication indices. But there is a contraindication for bimanual vaginal examinations, like virginity, because if the patient is virgin, it is not indicated to, not advised to do, not to vaginal examination. Critically unstable patient, medically or emotionally or psychologically, in availability of informed consent, because vaginal examination we should do. Obtain informed consent from the patient, and in case of some obstetrical complication like placenta previa, it is contraindicated to vaginal examination. This to show how to recto vaginal examinations and so. As a summary of this, Mrs. X, 17 years old, complaining of vaginal discharge for evaluation and management. This for you describes or take history and perform how to perform, I will describe how to perform examination for this lady and evaluate and manage her conditions. Okay. Thank you for you all and welcome. And further contact will be is my email mentioned here in this screen, mskin@ub.edu.sa. Thank you. Thank you very much and welcome for any further contact or explanation in through my email. Thank you for you all. Special regard and wishes for my student in University of Bisha, the fourth years, and I hope you to be succeed and to pass this situations, emerging situation about which wishes to teach you online and due to Corona. Virus pandemic, and thank you for you all, and thank you for all my students. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.